Hi everyone, bonjour, this is Sharig and welcome back to another lesson with Globetrot Arabic. This is a Lebanese Arabic language lesson dedicated to my Lebanese Arabic learners. It's going to be the continuation of the lesson we started 2 days ago when we spoke about the symptoms in relation to the coronavirus. Today we will talk about the precautions we can take to protect ourselves from the coronavirus. If you didn't do the first lesson, I will leave the link to part one in the description box down below. But I want to tell you something very important. Of course, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a health expert, and I'm not here to give you advice. I'm just here to teach you the terminologies in relation to this situation. So don't take this lesson as something to follow in terms of health, not at all. Just learn the vocabulary from it, okay? What else did I want to say? I also wanted to say that if you like my lessons, subscribe to my channel and follow me on Facebook and on Instagram, because I try to upload lessons there too almost on a daily basis. So for example, today when I finish recording this lesson with you here on YouTube, I will make sure to go to Facebook and to Instagram, and I will upload all the vocabulary we will do today and all the sentences and expressions. So if you want to save them with you, make sure to follow me there too. Let's begin. I will turn my camera and show you my screen. Okay guys, let's begin. As I told you, this is the continuation of the lesson we started the other day. As you can see here, scrolling up, you will notice I was talking about the symptoms related to the coronavirus. So make sure you go and do this lesson, and then you can come back to join us in this lesson. So as I mentioned, today we will talk about the precautions we can take to protect ourselves from the coronavirus. I started with a question and I said, طيب شو فينا نعمل؟ طيب شو فينا نعمل؟ This طيب, it means, okay, all right, what can we do? Why? Because I was speaking about all the symptoms, and when the lesson ended, I was like, okay, now that we know about all these symptoms, what can we do? That's why I used the word طيب here. طيب means okay, all right. But in another context, it means tasty. Of course, we don't mean tasty in this context. طيب, شو فينا نعمل? Okay, all right, what can we do? شو means what? فينا means we can. نعمل is we do. طيب, شو فينا نعمل? Okay, all right, what can we do? Another question I used is, شو هي الاحتياطات اللي فينا ناخدها تنحمي حالنا من الكورونا? You see, I said it really fast. Let me say it slowly. شو هي الاحتياطات يلي or اللي فينا ناخدها تنحمي حالنا من الكورونا? Let's break this down. شو means what? شو هي, what are? شو هي الاحتياطات, what are the precautions? The word احتياط means precaution. احتياطات means precautions. By the way, you have also the option of pronouncing it as احتياطات. I personally use احتياطات when I'm speaking Lebanese Arabic. In standard Arabic, they would say احتياطات. شو هي الاحتياطات? What are the precautions? Now you notice here I translated هي as what are. شو هي, I translated it as what are. But literally, هي means she. What she? I used a feminine singular pronoun because the word احتياطات is a plural word that is non-human. Every time you have a word that is non-human in Arabic, you can treat it as if it's a feminine singular word. This sounds a bit weird for those of you who are not used to this concept, but you can get used to it with time. So basically, this word, احتياطات, is a plural word. So I can use a feminine pronoun with it, a feminine singular verb with it, a feminine singular adjective with it, just because it's a plural of non-human. That's why here I said هي. Now when it comes to standard Arabic, this should be the case 100% of the times. But when it comes to Lebanese Arabic, I have the option of treating any non-human plural as if it's a feminine singular word or as if it's normal plural. So for example, I can say شو هي الاحتياطات in Lebanese Arabic, But I can also say شو هن الاحتياطات. And you notice here هن is the pronoun in the plural, which means they. So he is she and هن is they. شو هن الاحتياطات? What are the precautions? شو هي الاحتياطات? What are the precautions? And here you notice in Arabic we don't have a verb to be. It doesn't exist. It's like you are saying what she the precautions or what they the precautions. And here the ال means the precautions. So شو هن الاحتياطات or شو هي الاحتياطات يلي which فينا we can نخده take them. In Arabic you say which we can take them. In English you say which we take, which we can take. In Arabic you have to say which we can take them. In this case I used which we can take her. نخد is we take. And the a means take her. Why? Again, because it's related to this word here, which is احتياطات, which, as I said, is a non-human plural. That's why here I used the object pronoun, which we can take her, literally, basically. That's what I'm saying. But if I used شو هن الاحتياطات, شو هن الاحتياطات يلي فينا نخدون, in that case I say, because the on means them. Okay, so let me repeat. شو هن الاحتياطات يلي فينا نخدون, or شو هي الاحتياطات يلي فينا نخدا. Okay, you see the two options here. Now when it comes to يلي, you notice I put the word لي next to it. The لي is simply the abbreviation of يلي. So when I abbreviate it, I don't abbreviate it as لي, no, I abbreviate it as لي. So شو هي الاحتياطات اللي فينا نخدها, or شو هي الاحتياطات يلي فينا نخدها. Literally, I'm saying which we can take them, which means which we can take. شو هي الاحتياطات اللي فينا نخدها تنحمي حالنا من الكورونا. تنحمي حالنا من الكورونا. تنحمي means to protect, which means to, I'm saying to we protect, which means to protect. حالنا means ourselves, to protect ourselves. تنحمي حالنا من الكورونا, from the corona. من ال, من ال. So if I break it down, it's من, which is from, plus ال, which means the. I can say تنحمي حالنا من الكورونا. I can say that, it's perfectly fine. But I kind of abbreviated it and I joined them together in this word here, نل, نل كورونا. So I can say شو هي الاحتياطات اللي فينا نخدها تنحمي حالنا من الكورونا, or تنحمي حالنا من الكورونا. Okay, يلا, let's start with the precautions. So خلينا نبلش means let's start. خلينا نبلش بالاحتياطات. Let's start with the precautions. Okay, first of all, أكيد لازم نغسل إيدينا كتير منيح بالمي والصابون. I said it slowly, let me say it faster. I will use the natural speed. أكيد لازم نغسل إيدينا كتير منيح بالمي والصابون. أكيد means of course. أكيد. لازم means must. I mean here of course we must. أكيد لازم نغسل. نغسل means we wash. لازم نغسل means we have to wash. أكيد لازم نغسل. Of course we have to wash. إيدينا, our hands. So if I break إيدينا down, إيدين means hands. Plus A, إيدينا means our hands. Sorry, plus نا. إيدينا means our hands. But here, إيدين alone, hands. So I don't say إيدينا. It's, you could, but it doesn't sound very natural. That's why when I add the نا, which means our, I have to pronounce it إيدينا. Okay? So, أكيد, of course, لازم نغسل إيدينا. We have to wash our hands. كتير منيح. كتير means very. منيح means well or good. We have to wash our hands really well. أكيد لازم نغسل إيدينا كتير منيح بالمي. My means water. بالمي means with the water. That's how you say it in Arabic. B means with, and the il means the. Bi il mai, but I don't pronounce it bi il mai. I join them together and I say bil mai. I'm literally saying with the water, which means with water. Okay? Wassabun. Wassabun. W means and. Wassabun. Pronounced as, written as will sabun in Arabic, because the letter sa is a sun letter, the sad, so we are pronouncing it as wassabun. So I'm not pronouncing the lam here, okay? So wassabun, literally you are saying w and s l basically, which means the, and sabun means soap. So literally in English you say with soap and water. In Arabic you say with the soap and with the water. So wassabun and the soap, bilmai with the water. So the whole thing would be أكيد لازم نغسل إيدينا كتير منيح بالمي والصابون. Of course we have to wash our hands really well, very well, with water and soap. Now, the next precaution. احتياط, by the way. So, as I said, احتياطات is plural or احتياطات, and in the singular is احتياط. So, I can say here, تاني احتياط, the second precaution. So, for the first one, I can say أول احتياط. If you did the lesson last time, you already know that first means أول, and تاني means second. So, تاني احتياط. أول احتياط. أكيد لازم نغسل إيدينا. تاني احتياط. لازم نستعمل مطهر إيد فيه على القليلة 60% الكول. Let me repeat. A bit faster. لازم نستعمل مطهر إيد فيه على القليلة 60% الكول. Let's break it down. لازم, we must, نستعمل, we use. Literally in Arabic it's like you're saying must we use, which means we must use. لازم نستعمل. نستعمل. We have to use. So استعمل is the root when we add the ن, which means we use. So لازم نستعمل, we must use. لازم نستعمل مطهر. مطهر means literally it means a purifier, which means a sanitizer. So basically it comes also from the word tahar. يطهر, طهر in the past, يطهر in the present, which means to purify. So when I say لازم نستعمل مطهر, it means we have to use a sanitizer. مطهر إيد. إيد is the singular form of إيدين, which means hand. مطهر إيد, it means hand sanitizer. So لازم نستعمل مطهر إيد. I could have, of course, said مطهر للإيد, pronounced as للإيد in Lebanese Arabic. So مطهر للإيد, sanitizer for the hand, basically. But here I just said sanitizer of hand, which means a hand sanitizer. لازم نستعمل مطهر إيد. We have to use hand sanitizer, which means hand sanitizers. فيه على القليلة 60% الكول. فيو, literally you are saying in it. You notice here it's written in Arabic في, which means in, and هو, فيه, in standard Arabic. But in Lebanese Arabic we don't pronounce it فيه, we pronounce it فيو. This H is pronounced as a ي, and we're changing the he into a O. فيو, literally you are saying in it. It actually means literally in it, but you don't mean in it, you mean which has, okay? Or it has. Here, مطهر إيد فيو, a sanitizer which has, على قليلة. على قليلة means at least, على قليلة. Just memorize it like that, at least. فيو على قليلة Sittin bilmiye. Bilmiye means percent. Sittin bilmiye. Alcohol. You notice here I used the French word because most of the times we use that word in Lebanese Arabic. We wouldn't say kohoul, for example, which means alcohol. We just say alcohol in French, okay? So we have. So this sentence means we have to use a hand sanitizer that has or which has at least 60% alcohol. Let me repeat the sentence. لازم نستعمل مطهر إيد فيه على القليلة 60% alcohol. Okay? So we did. So we did أول احتياط, تاني احتياط. Now we will do تالت احتياط, the third precaution. تالت احتياط. I will read it fast. ما لازم كتير نقرب عن الناس اللي ما منعرفهم بهالفترة لأنه الفيروس بيعدي. Okay, let me repeat this a bit slower. ما لازم كتير نقرب عن الناس يلي ما منعرفهم بهالفترة لأنه الفيروس بيعدي. Let's break this down. لازم, we said it means we must. ما لازم, we shouldn't. ما لازم كتير نقرب. نقرب means we come close to. كتير نقرب, we come close to a lot. ما لازم كتير نقرب, we shouldn't come close to a lot. Okay? عن الناس. Literally in Arabic you are saying on the people, which means to the people. In Arabic it's written here as عن الناس, but we're pronouncing it as عن الناس. Why? Because the noon here is a sun letter, so we don't pronounce the L here. So it's literally like you are saying on the people, which means to the people. So we shouldn't come close to the people a lot. Now let me continue. ما لازم كتير نقرب عن الناس يلي ما منعرفة. There is a hidden meme behind this guy. يلي ما منعرفة. ما منعرفة or منعرفون. Okay? So عن الناس, to the people, يلي, which, منعرف, we know. منعرفون, we know them. ما منعرفون, we don't know them. I could have also said ما منعرفة. Why? Because ناس is a plural that we can treat as a feminine singular. ناس يلي ما منعرفة. In that case, I would have used the object pronoun, which is in the feminine singular form. Here, on literally means them, we know them, which we know them or which we don't know them. In English, you would say which we don't know. In Arabic, you have to say which we don't know them. Okay, so ما لازم كتير نقرب, we shouldn't come close to a lot, عن الناس, to the people, يلي, which, or who, ما منعرفون, we don't know them, which means to the people we don't know. Of course, here the يلي could have also been abbreviated into لي, عن الناس اللي ما منعرفون بهالفترة. بهالفترة means in this phase. فترة means phase. بهالفترة. بهالفترة. But I could have also said بهالفترة. Let me break بهالفترة down. ب means in. هيدي means this. Plus ال means the. It's like you are saying in this the phase. فترة. That's how you say it in Arabic. بهيدي الفترة. I can put them together. بهيدي الفترة. This is the non-abbreviated form. But all this B plus هيدي plus إل is abbreviated into one little word here, which is بهالفترة. Okay? Which means in this phase. In English, you say in this phase. In Arabic, it's weird, but the way you say it, it's in this the phase, which means in this phase basically. So the whole thing would mean we shouldn't come very close to the people which we don't know in this phase. لأنه الفيروس بيعدي. لأنه means because. Virus means the virus. I'm using the French word virus. Bi'ade means it contaminates or it contagious. That's a verb, which means it's contagious basically. But here you're using a verb. You're saying it's contagious, which doesn't exist in English. So لأنه الفيروس بيعدي, because the virus contaminates or it contagious literally, which means it is contagious. So ما لازم كتير نقرب عن الناس اللي ما منعرفهم بهالفترة لأنه الفيروس بيعدي. Okay, so أول احتياط, تاني احتياط, تالت احتياط, and now we will do رابع احتياط. رابع احتياط. Actually, you know what? Let me write أول, first. تاني, second. تالت, third. And رابع, fourth. So here I'm gonna do رابع احتياط. رابع احتياط. So شو هو الاحتياط الرابع? What is the fourth precaution? ما لازم نسلم بالإيد. ما لازم نسلم بالإيد. ما لازم means we shouldn't. نسلم. نسلم means to say hi, to greet. So ما لازم نسلم, we shouldn't greet. بالإيد, literally you are saying with the hand, which means by hand. ما لازم نسلم بالإيد, we shouldn't greet by hand. Literally it means with the hand. B plus L pronounced as بالإيد, with the hand. We shouldn't greet by hand. ما لازم نسلم بالإيد. So we said أول, تاني, تالت, رابع. And now we will say the fifth precaution. خامس احتياط. خامس احتياط. Or I can also say الاحتياط الخامس. خامس احتياط. Okay, so شو هو الاحتياط الخامس? What is the fifth precaution? ما لازم ندق بالوجه, بالتم أو بالعيون. Let me say it again. ما لازم ندق بالوجه, بالتم أو بالعيون. Now I will say it a bit faster with natural speed. ما لازم ندق بالوجه, بالتم أو بالعيون. ما لازم ندق. We shouldn't touch. ندق means we touch. ما لازم ندق means we shouldn't touch. بالوجه means to the face. وجه means face. بالوجه means literally to the face, which means we shouldn't touch our faces. I'm just saying to the face. بالوجه. ما لازم ندق بالوجه, بالتم, which means to the mouth. تم means mouth. بالتم means to the mouth. أو بالعيون. عيون means eyes. بالعيون, literally you are saying to the eyes. أو means or. ما لازم ندق بالوجه, بالتم أو بالعيون. I could have of course said ما لازم ندق بالوجه أو بالتم أو بالعيون, which actually is better in Arabic. In English you say I shouldn't touch the face, the mouth or the eyes. In Arabic we repeat or. ما لازم ندق بالوجه أو بالتم أو بالعيون. We shouldn't touch the face, the mouth or the eyes. So this was خامس احتياط. هيدا كان خامس احتياط. This was the fifth precaution. Now we will talk about the sixth precaution, which is سادس احتياط. سادس, which means sixth. سادس احتياط. This one I don't know, so I just said I don't know. ما بعرف إذا لازم نلبس كمامات. ما بعرف إذا لازم نلبس كمامات. I don't know if we should wear masks, face masks. ما بعرف, I don't know. بعرف means I know. ما بعرف means I don't know. ما بعرف إذا, إذا means if. لازم, it means we should. نلبس means we wear. ما بعرف إذا لازم نلبس. I don't know if we should wear Kmemet, kmemet is face masks. Kmeme is one face mask. Kmemet is face masks. And as I told you in the previous lesson, kmemet is not usually the mask you wear on Halloween or something like that. No, it's the medical face mask. Kmeme, kmemet. And finally, here we will talk about the mental benefits. وأهم شيء or أهم شيء. You can pronounce it as أهم شيء or أهم شيء. أهم شيء means the most important thing, which means and most importantly. وأهم شيء, most importantly, but literally I'm saying and the most important thing. وأهم شيء or وأهم شيء. لازم نعمل رياضة تنقوي مناعتنا. Let me repeat this. لازم نعمل رياضة تنقوي مناعتنا. لازم means we must. نعمل means we do. رياضة means sports. And of course I could have said sport because that's what we say most of the times in Lebanese Arabic. We use the French word basically. So لازم نعمل رياضة أو لازم نعمل سبور تنقوي مناعتنا. تنقوي مناعتنا. نقوي means we strengthen. تنقوي means to strengthen. Literally we are saying to we strengthen, which means to strengthen, or better said, so that we strengthen, basically. تنقوي, so that we strengthen. مناعتنا. So the word مناعة, مناعة, means immunity. But when I want to add the na, which means our immunity, I don't say مناعنا. No, I have to pronounce it مناعتنا. Why? Because the actual word in Arabic finishes, if you look here, مناعة, it finishes with a T marbuta. And we know that this T marbuta is a silent letter. It's not pronounced when the word is alone. So the word alone is pronounced as مناعة. But the moment I attach a pronoun to it, which in this case is the na, of course I don't say مناعنا. No, I have to pronounce the T marbuta. And I say مناعتنا. And the fatha here of مناعة kind of becomes like a kasra. مناعتنا, مناعتنا. Okay? So مناعتنا means our immunity. So لازم نعمل رياضة تنقوي مناعتنا. We have to do sports so we strengthen our immunity. The next one is لازم ناكل أكل صحي. لازم ناكل أكل صحي. لازم ناكل is we must eat. ناكل is we eat. لازم ناكل is we must eat. أكل صحي. صحي means healthy. أكل صحي means healthy food. You notice in Arabic, I'm not saying healthy food. I'm saying food healthy. Why? Because always in Arabic, we put our adjectives after our nouns, not before. So, لازم ناكل أكل صحي. We must eat food healthy, which means healthy food. وأخيراً, أخيراً means finally. وأخيراً, finally. لازم دايماً ندعم بعض. لازم دايماً or دايماً ندعم بعض. So this word can be pronounced as دايماً or دايماً. It's up to you. Really, you have the choice. They're the same. لازم دايماً or دايماً ندعم بعض. لازم ندعم. ندعم means we give motivation to each other. لازم ندعم, we motivate, we must motivate. بعض means each other. Here, be careful. I didn't say بعض. بعض with a small d in Arabic, it should be written بعض. It's different. This one is بعض, as you can see here, up here. بعض. So this is the difference between the two, بعض and بعض. بعض means each other. بعض means yet or after. So this one is not بعض, it's بعض, which means each other in this context. So make sure to pronounce it like in a strong way, بعض, rather than بعض. So لازم دايما ندعم بعض. We must always push each other. Nadam bad means push each other or give each other motivation. So daiman means always. I could have of course said lazim nadam bad daiman. So I can take this always and put it at the end of the sentence. I even have the option of putting it at the beginning of the sentence. Daiman lazim nadam bad. But there is a tiny difference when I say daiman lazim bad. It's kind of like you are stressing on the word always. We should always do it. Like there's a stress when you put it at the beginning of the sentence. Okay? So, lazim daiman nadam bad. We should always support each other, motivate each other. Actually, nadam is more support. I would translate it as support more than motivate. Okay? Support each other. And finally, this is my humble opinion. Let me read it faster and then I will break it down. وبرأيي لازم نعمل شيء منحبه وبريحنا. مثلا نسمع موسيقى أو نعمل تمارين بتريح الراس مثل التأمل. حيلا شيء بخلينا نرتاح. Let me repeat. برأيي لازم نعمل شيء منحبه وبريحنا. مثلا نسمع موسيقى أو نعمل تمارين بتريح الراس مثل التأمل. And then I said, حيلا شي بخلينا نرتاح. Let's break this down. برأيي means in my opinion. ب means in. رأي means opinion. And رأيي means my opinion. In my opinion, برأيي لازم نعمل. We must do. لازم نعمل شي. We must do something منحبه. Literally, I'm saying we like it. I used it here. Oh, why? Because I'm talking about she. We must do something we like it. So in English, you say we must do something we like. In Arabic, we are saying we must do something we like it. Okay? So, برأيي, in my opinion, لازم نعمل شي منحبه. We should do something we like or we love. وبريحنا, and it relaxes us. و means and. بريح means it relaxes. بريحنا means it relaxes us. Again, we're talking about she. That's why we are using a singular verb, which is بريح. Literally, it means he relaxes or it relaxes, because we're talking about something that relaxes. So لازم نعمل شيء منحبه وبيريحنا. We must do something we love and it relaxes us. مثلا نسمع موسيقى. For example, we hear music. I can also say here, مثلا فينا نسمع موسيقى. We can hear music. مثلا فينا نسمع موسيقى. مثلا, for example, فينا, we can, نسمع, we hear. So in Arabic, it's like you are saying we can, we hear, rather than we can hear. مثلا فينا نسمع موسيقى. موسيقى means music. أو, or فينا نعمل, we can do. I can also say, of course, أو نعمل. I don't have to say فينا نعمل. أو نعمل or do تمارين, exercises. بتريح, بتريح means it relaxes, you see. بتريح. In this case, I didn't say بتريحنا. Why? Because I'm going to say بتريح الراس. It relaxes. Literally, I'm saying the head, but it means it relaxes. It relaxes the mind. بتريح الراس. So here in Arabic, if you look at the word, is بتريح الراس. It's written with this ال. But in here, with Latin letters, I wrote الراس because I'm writing the phonetic representation, because we shouldn't pronounce it بتريح الراس. We should pronounce it بتريح الراس, because the letter ر here, the ر, is a sun letter. And every time we have a sun letter and all the words that start with a ر, if they have a L before them, we shouldn't pronounce the ل الراس. We should pronounce الراس. So, مثلا نسمع موسيقى أو نعمل تمارين بتريح الراس. For example, we can hear music or we hear music or do exercises that relax the mind or the head. مثل التأمل. مثل التأمل. تأمل means meditation. It also can mean contemplation, but in this context I meant meditation. مثل التأمل, such as meditation. Literally, I'm saying مثل, which means like, التأمل, but I'm pronouncing it التأمل, again, because the T is a sun letter, so I don't say التأمل, even if in Arabic it's written as التأمل, as you see here, it's written with a إل, التأمل, but we have to pronounce it التأمل. So it's like you are saying, like the meditation, which means such as meditation, basically. مثل التأمل, such as meditation. And then I put dot dot dot, and then I said, حيالله شي بخلينا نرتاح. حيالله شي, حيالله means anything, literally. حيالله شي, anything. حيالله شي, anything بخلينا, بخلي means it lets. بخلينا, it lets us. بخلينا نرتاح, it lets us relax. حيالله شي بخلينا نرتاح. Anything, it lets us relax, literally, which means anything that lets us relax or anything that makes us relax. حيالله شي بخلينا نرتاح. Let me read this. برأيي لازم نعمل شي منحبه وبيريحنا. مثلا نسمع موسيقى أو نعمل تمارين بتريح الراس مثل التأمل. حيالله شي بخلينا نرتاح. Anything that makes us relax. I think that's it for today. I really hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, as I always tell you. And also, make sure to write in the comment box below, what are your ways of dealing with this situation? And what are your favorite activities in this time? And yeah, I will turn my camera right now and say bye to you. That's it for today. I hope you found it useful. If you did, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye! بشوفكم بكره!